this CNBC TV 18 special. As the channel turns 17, we are a year older and wiser. Every year, the markets threw up new challenges. The last year brought with it Brexit, the Trump victory, demonetization, and we saw the Nifty swing wildly between that 6,900 mark on the Nifty to 8,900. But here we are, almost at 2017, and to navigate through these volatile and difficult times that may lie ahead, our market walas join us today with not one, not two, but 17 stock ideas. Hi, Anuj. We've seen a bit of a correction in the recent past. Is it a good time to go stock shopping?
I think the index has told you that. The mid-cap index this year is up 8%, while the Sensex and Nifty have remained flat. So if the index is up 8%, a smart stock picker would have easily made at least 20-25%, and that's what we are here for. We'll tell our viewers 17 stocks, and some of the best stock pickers are here.
Yes, 17 for 2017. So let me introduce our panel of experts. We have with us Mr. S.P. Tulsian, Dipan Mehta, Daljeet Kohli, as well as Prakash Tiwan.
Of course, we also have our own research team and the reporting team here. So they'll be also quizzing our experts. So it's going to be a fun session, a lot of stock picking and also a lot of questions and answers. Let me start then, Mr. Tulsian, first up to you. Zee Media, a stock that you've liked in the past as well. But what are the triggers now and what are the price targets here?
See, Anuj, the earlier idea was on the channel that they will be closing down or hiving off the print business, that is DNA Mumbai. Earlier, the paper was published from two locations, Mumbai and Bangalore. They suspended it. Bangalore, now they are hiving off the print business to a separate subsidiary company, which implies that probably they'll exit from this business. But the recent development which has happened, that the company has acquired 59 radio channels from ADAG Group for about 1,600 crore. And that will really be a big kicker. If you see the, just to give a comparative example, ENIL, which is third in the slot in the radio broadcasting business with about 55 or 56 radio broadcasting channels. If I just give you the financial performance, because that will spell out everything, that they had for first half, that is H1 FY17, income of 240 crore. And the EBITDA was at closure to about 54 crore. And the radio business, 59 channels, which they are acquiring now, the Zee Media, the turnover is about 368 crore and EBITDA is 98 crore. That means 50% more. What ENIL is commanding now, the market cap of 3,400 crore and the enterprise value of closure to about 3,700 crore. Come on, Zee Media, the present standalone business, they own 10 regional and national channels, and the regional channels are all entire North Belt, whether you talk of Rajasthan, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Bengal, Odisha, UP, and in Maharashtra. And in each locations, they have 50% market share. And if you see the present market cap of closure to about 1,600 crore, and if you add the debt of consolidated debt of 400 crore, EV of 2,000 crore, they are acquiring 1,600 crore, the fresh which they will be paying 3,600 crore. Even that is still lower than the enterprise value of ENIL. And they may realize about 500 to 600 crore by selling off the print business, because the infrastructure and the machinery, the tangible assets are seen quite high to the extent of about 500 crore. So if you have this 70% promoter stake, I think they are deep rooted. The Z Group is deep rooted into the general entertainment channel and even in this thing also. And the acquisition of this radio business is very much synergistic to the existing operations. Right now, it is said that 51% is getting acquired, but 49 is only for to meet the statutory compliances, and very tiny amount of about 12 crore will be paid to acquire that 49%. But the agreement has been drafted in such a manner that eventually in next 24 months, 100% ownership of 59 radio channels will come. So a combination of TV channels and radio channels, and with this present price of 35, I am expecting the share to move closer to about 55 rupees in next 1 year till we celebrate the next 18th anniversary of the channel.
Well, I remember he had last year picked MCX, and that's a stock which gave a 50% return just in the last 1 year. But Prakash, let me come to you. Your recommendation is Trent.
Yeah, that's right. Very, very simple. Nobody's touching the Tata Group. But I thought, let me find something which still offers value. And this happens to be a Tata Group company. It's actually the umbrella entity for all the retail stores that I'm sure you love visiting. Westside, Croma, Landmark, Star Bazaar. And what I think has happened is, if you see the numbers, I won't spend too much time on the numbers, but just to give you a context, out of the 1,500 crore top line, they've actually managed about 5% net profits, which in a business like this is phenomenal, you know. And it's gone under-celebrated of sorts. This year has not been a great start. You just had 6 months where they've clocked about 7.5 rupees of EPS. But going forward with digitization, the onslaught of digitization, a lot of grocery buying is going to happen from these organized retail outlets and not necessarily from the Baniya store that you have. Star Bazaar is actually expanding because of that. Westside is already present in about 50 cities. And I think they have a lot of unlocked value in Inditex, which is the Zara ownership, right? So I'm sure all of you girls will go and spend money there. They'll make money there. They also have a Lakefield JV, which is a UK home appliance, kitchen appliances unit, which is doing very well all over the world. They probably would start expanding. They just have a couple of stores, I remember. But, you know, it's a story that will start getting re-rated. So I'm not looking at an EPS growth necessarily at this point, but the re-rating definitely gives it a huge, huge upside potential. I'm giving it a target of about 299 from the current levels, which is also quite good, but you'll probably have to wait a year and a half for that.
Okay. Mangalam Tractor Stock, you have a query for Prakash?
Yeah, my question would be not particularly on Trent, but why just Trent in specific while you have other options in the retail space? You have the whole Future Group, you have ABFRL, and then you also have Arvind, which is doing a lot of brands. So why Trent in particular? Because
no, absolutely,
Arvind has stronger brands, right?
No, Mangalam, very valid question. Look at the product segments that it caters to. You have grocery and household items. You have electronics. You have apparel. You have other general stuff which the Westside brand also covers. And you have Landmark, which is books, entertainment, digital, the same media and all of that. Whereas if you take any other retail chain, they are very deeply focused on one of these four verticals. You know, they're not necessarily like ABFRL is not going to be in groceries. They're not going to be selling watches. They're not going to be selling furniture, right? So this gives you an entire gamut of spend, and the loyalty levels in the Westside stores is one of the highest, by the way. You know, they don't talk about these numbers much, but if you go by the statistics that come through, the footfall is high in most malls and departmental stores, but people just enjoy the air-conditioned environment, do a little bit of window shopping, come out. But Westside, it's not the case. So I think that differentiates this model much better than some of the other names.
Prakash, just a follow-up question on this as well. What about the timing? Given the fact that there's a lot being spoken about how discretionary spending will probably get hit over the next half, is this the right time to be getting in? And I take your point about the net profit margin.
Yeah.
What about top-line growth and things like same-store sales?
Yeah, so I think this is going to be an opportunity for the organized sector, because you had a, you know, I'll give you my example. At my place, we had the local vegetable vendor would send whatever you wanted over the phone, you paid cash and it was over. Now to conserve that cash, which suddenly has become precious, you actually don't mind going to a Godrej Nature's Basket or a Star Bazaar.
Not
or
F&B. I was asking this more from the point of view of Westlife, the discretionary part of it.
Yeah, so that also will take a little bit of a slow, this thing, you know, trajectory for a time being. It's not that people will not have money. They don't have cash. People, income levels might not go down. The cash component in the income level is going down. So I don't think that's going to impact. And they are present in more tier one kind of locations where this problem is not so severe.
Okay. Let's do one thing. Of course, we can have maybe one more session where we'll, you know, quiz, you know, Prakash and a lot of experts about discretionary consumption, since that's a topic that you like, Surbhi, and you've done a lot of research on that. But let's move on for now. Deepan, let's talk about your first pick. Strides Arcolab, or Strides Shasun as we know it now. What's the key theme here?
First of all, congratulations on completing 17 years. And, you know, when you want to look at pharma companies, you want to go for the entrepreneurs in the pharma business, because truly this one industry which is entrepreneurial driven, and Mr. Arun Kumar is one of the best examples of a good pharma entrepreneur. He's created value, distributed value, and now again he's coming back to creating value for the company. Many acquisitions done over the years, now all of them have got assimilated. Management has said that any further acquisition will be highly selective, only to complete some of the parts which they don't have in the business. Multiple growth drivers. They are going very aggressively into Africa with a differentiated business model. Australian acquisition is going to be a major money spinner for them as they start moving products to manufacture into India. And they just about started the US generics business. And domestically also, they've acquired some interesting brands. So I think multiple growth drivers for Shasun. And at a time like this, you know, when there is uncertainty as far as consumer spending is concerned and domestic-oriented businesses concerned in the wake of demonetization, I think investors should look at pharma as a safe haven. So that's where I think amongst all the stocks, I think Shasun could give a good return going forward.
Very often we bet on the man, not the company per se. But Daljeet, coming to you, sticking with pharma, Jubilant Life?
Yes, Jubilant Life, actually we started long back when they were coming out of their bad phase. Basically, this company has two divisions. 50% comes from pharma, 50% comes from chemicals. Now, chemicals, we all know, is down because of input prices. Commodities are down. But a commendable fact about this company is that despite realization going down, their margins are still intact, or in fact slightly better in last two quarters in chemicals. In pharma, where they have gone into losses because of the problems with FDA in Spokane and Montreal facility, those problems are now over. So now they are actually back into good numbers. So actually the margins have now come to 22-25%. So in last two quarters they have added 600 basis points in margins. So that's the big thing which has helped. Now the why we still choose it, because the stock has already moved 100% or so in the last 6-7 months. The point is that they have 4,000 crore debt in their books, which is mostly denominated in dollars. So that's a big negative also. But the good thing is that now cash flows are coming. If they start repaying that debt, that will get added into the enterprise value. So market cap will go up. So that's the idea, that even if, as of today, if I do SOTP basis valuation, then pharma, if I give 8 or 9 times of EV to EBITDA and chemical only 5 times, still I'm getting 800 rupees. But if these multiples actually are lower than the average multiple. So you can actually go to 900 or 1,000 once these debt gets repaid.
All right, let's do one. Let me just get started, of course. We've got 4 stocks, 13 more left. We'll take a break and be back with the second set of picks.